Hello, my name is Dr. Ibrahimian, and in this channel, I go over problem-solving strategies, mainly as it relates to math competitions. So here is a problem from International Math Olympiad in 2024. Shortlisted problem N1. Find all positive integers N with the following property. For all positive divisors D of N, we have either D plus 1 divides N or D plus 1 is prime. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with looking at different possibilities of N and see if we can find a pattern, and then hopefully we can extend that pattern to create a proof. So the first observation is N equals 1 clearly satisfies the property because the only divisor is 1 and D plus 1 is in fact prime. Then N equals 2 gives us the divisors of 1 and 2, and D plus 1 is 2 and 3. So that is also an additional example that satisfies the property. N equals 3. The divisors are 1 and 3. D plus 1 is 2 and 4. And this is clearly not going to satisfy the property because 4 does not divide 3. And of course, 4 is not prime. So at this point, I can easily see N plus 1 must divide N, or N plus 1 is prime. So, well, we clearly know that N plus 1 doesn't divide N. So this means N plus 1 is prime. So that's the first observation that we have. Okay, so this is the first thing. So which means if I start with looking at n's that are 4 or above, then that means n must be even. So let's look at this. So far we have found two examples, n1 and n2, and every other example would have to be even. So we'll have to test the numbers that are 1 less than prime. So the next prime would be 5. So 1 less than that is 4. So n equals 4. The divisors are 1, 2, and 4. D plus 1 is 2, 3, and 5. In fact, all of them are prime. So n equals 4 is a possibility. So the next prime after 5 is 7. So 6 is the next possible number, 1, 2, 3, and 6, and D plus 1 is going to be 2, 3, 4, and 7, and in fact, this is problematic, so this is not a possibility. So the next prime after 7 is 11, so the divisors are 1, and I have to subtract 1 from that, so I get 10, 1, 2, 5, and 10, D plus 1 is 2, 3, 6, and 11, and this is problematic. So the next possibility is 13 minus 1, which is 12, and D is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. And if we look at D plus 1, we get 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and 13. And in fact, this is a possibility. The next prime after 13 is 17. 16 is the next possibility. So we get 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. So D plus 1 is 2, 3, 5, 9, and 17, and this is a problem. So we noticed that we found a bunch of examples, and we have 1, 2, 4, and 12. These are the examples that we found, and we also found that N plus 1 is prime. From now on, let's assume that N is more than 12, and let's figure out, or more than in fact 16, and let's figure out if we have some properties about this N. So I looked at properties of N and see if I can find something. So I know that 2 divides N. So since 2 divides N, because N plus 1 is prime, so that means there are two possibilities. Either 3 divides N or 3 is prime. So this doesn't really tell me anything about N, because I know that 3 is prime, so this is really not going to help. So the next thing that I do is that I'm going to look at other factors of N. So I know that 2 divides N, so on the other side of the divisors, I can look at N over 2. So I know that N over 2 divides N. So that tells us that either N over 2 plus 1 divides N, or N over 2 plus 1 is prime. But of course, because N over 2 plus 1 is prime, that means N plus 2 over 2 is prime. Now notice that this is really not possible because N over 2 is the largest factor of N besides N. And N is more than 16. So this means N plus 2 isn't 0 mod 3. But we also know that the n plus 1 is prime. So that means n plus 1 is also not 0 mod 3. So this tells us that n must be 0 mod 3, which means 3 divides n. And since 3 divides n, either 4 divides n or 4 is prime, but of course 4 is n prime. So that tells us that 4 must divide n. So this means that if n is greater than 16, then 12 must divide n. So I started looking at factors again, but I didn't really get much out of this, because really 12 satisfies the properties. And if you look at the other side of the divisors, which are n over 2, n over 3, n over 4, n over 6, and n over 12, they don't really give you a whole lot. They give you some congruences, but it's not very convenient to use those. Then I went back and looked at the examples that I had, and I noticed that the contradictions that I got, or the things that didn't work, came from the largest odd factor of n. Here we got it from 6, here we got it from, or rather 5, and here we got it from 3. And here we also got from the largest factor, but right before 16. So I decided that I have to look at the condition, which is d divides n implies d plus 1 divides n, or d plus 1 is prime. And I would really hope that I can get rid of this or here, because if I can get rid of this or, then I can easily say if d divides n, then d plus 1 divides n, or if d divides n, then d plus 1 is prime. So how can I get rid of that or? Well, I know that if d is odd, so if I say d divides n and d is odd, then that definitely implies that d plus 1 divides n, which means I can create more divisors of n. So let's look at the extreme case of the divisors that are odd. So what is that extreme case? That means I should write down 2 as n as 2 to the a times b, where b is odd. And by the discussion that we have, a is at least 2 and b is in fact at least 3. And we in fact know that b is divisible by 3. So I'm looking at the numbers that are larger than 16. So let's look at this and see what I can get. So what are the divisors? I can say b divides n, I can say 2b divides n, I can say 4b divides n, I can say 2 to the a divides n, and I can say 2 to the a minus 1 divides n. So I have like a bunch of possibilities, and for each one of them I try to see what I get, and I'm going to do maybe a couple of them and I'll show you exactly which ones I used. So if b divides n, that means there are two possibilities: either b plus 1 divides n, or b plus 1 is prime. But I know that b plus 1 is even, so b plus 1 must divide n. So that means b plus 1 divides 2 to the a times b, which means b plus 1 must divide 2 to the a. So this is really nice. That tells us that b plus 1 is 2 to the k for some k less than or equal to a, because it's a factor of a power of 2. I can look at this one. This would give me 2b plus 1 divides n, or 2b plus 1 is prime. And in fact, I can go through this process and see that in fact 2b plus 1 is prime is in fact the consequence of what I get. And then I can do the same thing for 4b, but really what worked were these last two along with the first one. So 2 to the a divides n, so that means there are two possibilities: either 2 to the a plus 1 divides n, or 2 to the a plus 1 is prime. And this one tells us that either 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 divides n, or 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 is prime. So let's look at each of these cases and see what happens. So if 2 to the a plus 1 divides n, then 2 to the a plus 1 divides 2 to the a times b, which means 2 to the a plus 1, because it's odd, must divide b. But b is 2 to the k minus 1, which is less than 2 to the a plus 1. So that's not going to happen. So this tells us that 2 to the a plus 1 is in fact prime. But interestingly, we can do the same thing with 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 as well. So let's do the same thing. If 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 divides n, That means 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 divides b. But again, b is 2 to the k minus 1. But if that's the case, so this means 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 times some number would have to be 2 to the k minus 1. Now, let's look at this number m. So there are a couple of possibilities for m. If m is 1, then that means 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 would have to be 2 to the k minus 1, which means 2 to the a minus 1 plus 2 is going to be 2 to the k, which tells us that a minus 1 and 1 must be the same. These exponents must be the same so that they add up to another exponent of another power of 2. And k must be 2. So this means a and k are both 2. So if a and k are both 2, this means n is equal to 2 to the a, which is 2, times 2 squared minus 1, which is in fact 12, and that's the number that we already knew. So this is not going to give us anything new. Now, otherwise, so I have 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 times m is 2 to the k minus 1, and both of these are odd. This is odd, and this is odd. So this means m can be at least 3, it cannot be 2. But if that is the case, then 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1 times m would be at least 3 times 2 to the a minus 1 plus 1, which is larger than 2 to the a. Well, but that's larger than 2 to the k minus 1, because k is less than or equal to a. So that's not going to happen. Therefore, the consequence of this discussion is that 2 to the power of a minus 1 plus 1 is also prime. So let's summarize what we got. What we got was that 2 to the a plus 1 and 2 to the power of a minus 1 plus 1 are both prime. But it's an easy exercise from number theory that if 2 to the a plus 1 is prime, then a must be a power of 2. So a and a minus 1 are powers of 2. How can we have two consecutive numbers that are powers of 2? So the only way that could happen is if a is 2 and a minus 1 is 1, which is 2 to the 0, basically. So that's the only possibility. And if a is 2, then n would be 2 squared times 2 to the k minus 1. Depending on what k is, it could be 2 squared times 2 to the 1 minus 1, or it could be 2 squared times 2 squared minus 1, because remember that k was less than or equal to a. And this again doesn't give us anything new. It gives us 4 or 12. Therefore, the answer to the problem is 1, 2, 4, or 12. And these are the only possible answers. And that brings me to the end of this video. So I will see you in the next video.